Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Karen the Karrot, and for those of you who don't know me, I normally make roller skating content here on YouTube. So today I wanted to show you guys really quickly how to put bearings on your new wheels and then put them on your skates. I know that a lot of people got into roller skating recently and you might want to do like an upgrade, like get some new wheels or laces or something. But I also know that a lot of people don't know how to do it, or they might have an idea but want to see it done. So today I'm going to show you guys, so let's go. And actually, when I first got into skating, I had no idea what bearings were or that wheels needed them and that they were extra and all that stuff. So yeah, I'll teach you everything that I wish I knew and that I know now. So yeah. So here are my sure grip roller skates. These are called the golden hour skates, and I've had these for about 4 months now. I actually made a first impression video on these, and I've also made a 4 month update review on these. And if you haven't watched that, I basically say that I really like these skates and I actually wanted to give them a little upgrade, starting with wheels. I do need new toe stops and laces. But today I wanted to show you guys how to put bearings into your wheels. So that's what we're gonna do. Here I have these Pulse wheels. They're clear and have little specks of gold glitter, and I think they're really cute. I actually wanna dye these, but they're new and I'm excited and I'm gonna try them out first and then I'm gonna scrub them. I kinda wanna see how dirty they get before I dye them to, you know, just to see. These are $75 for a pack of 8, and you can get these and these skates at pigeonskates.com. Use code Karrot for a discount. And I also have these Cube Juice bearings. These are 16 bearings because we have 8 wheels. We need 2 bearings for each. And then I have a couple of skate tools. A lot of people always ask me like where you can get them, and you can get them at any skate shop, but you know, I'm gonna tell you to go to pigeonskates.com. This one right here runs for about $10, and it has like the three fittings for the nuts and different types of things. This one is specifically for these kind of skates that have an adjustable toe stop. So you put it right here and you fix it. If you have a bolt-on toe stop, like an Impala, then this kind of tool, if you take this out, you can use it to like remove the toe stop, or if you need to adjust it. I would honestly recommend just getting a screwdriver because this is little and sometimes it's not like there's not enough force that you end up like scraping the bolt and then it's stripped and then you can't really use it. But this is good for like emergencies. So yeah, this one runs for about like $10, and this one runs about for $20, but it's like really good quality, like it's really like sturdy, and it's always sold out though. So that's kind of like what sucks about this, because it's like so good that everyone wants it that it's always sold out. And then we have like this little crab tool that, again, like you can use it for all of the parts, and this is for the toe stop. This, using this to take off a toe stop is kind of like using this one, because like it hurts your hand and it's kind of like, it's for like emergencies. So I would recommend this one, but this one usually comes with like skates. I got this one with my Moonlight roller skates, and I know if you get like the Moxie Lolly, they usually come with them too. So yeah, definitely need one of these if you're gonna be skating. Okay, I'm gonna open these wheels up and the bearings, and then I'm gonna take off these. And really quickly, you're just gonna use any of them that finds and turn it to the left and twist it a bunch. Take this nut out and then boom. So yeah, let me finish doing this. Ta-da! Nike skates are so much lighter. Like, most of the weight is on the wheels. Okay, so now with these bearings, I took them out of the box. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put one in the front and one in the back. And we're gonna use our skate to put pressure on them and make sure that they're on tight. You could also do this with a bearing tool, but I don't have one. And again, like this one, they've been sold out for a minute, so we're gonna do it the old school way and just press it on. And yeah, I haven't used these bearings, but they seem pretty good, and this brand makes that a bottle for you to clean them, so you know, pretty legit standard bearings. And these run for about like $30 a box, so you know. So I'm gonna get this bearing with the face down first, put it right in here. I'm gonna put my wheel and I'm gonna press on it. And then it's on, pretty good. And then I'm gonna put this one, but actually this way. And oops. Okay, this one's on pretty good, but I kind of like pushed that one out. You could also, to push it in, get like this part and press it on the side. And that way you'll make sure that it's really on there, and just give it a spin. There we go. Nice. And at first when you spin them, it's gonna be a little bit slow because you need to give like time for the oil to like really start working. But yeah, you can just put this back on and put your nut. But I'm gonna do the other ones first. So let's do another one real quickly. Down. Okay. Down. And when you're pressing your bearing down, try to only touch like the metal part and not go directly on the orange. So I try to like level it out, and that way it's in. And that one's good. So let's do the other ones. Okay, so now that all of our wheels have bearings, it's just time to put them back on your skates. I'm just gonna pop them in there, add your nut, and with your tool, you're gonna tighten it. I actually like to put them all on my skates first and do like a quick, I'll do like four wheels first. Just add it very loosely. And then I go in one by one and just tighten it. Wait, this is not this way, righty tighty, lefty loosey. I'm gonna turn it like just enough that it like still rolls and it's not like stopping you. So see, that's better. And you don't want them to click, so right now they're not clicking. This would be like an example of clicking, and this means that like your nut is too loose and it could fall off. So do that again for all your wheels. It's too slow, loosen it a little bit. And that's how they should be. You're right, because people don't know that. Yeah, like, oh, like my wheels are too, like I feel slow, you know?
Yeah, and they're like, or when they're really tight and they're new, they forget to do
so. Yeah, so this is not good. You want them to like roll like the wind, you know? And they'll get faster because they're new bearings.
Oh, they have some flakes here.
I know. They're gonna get dirty though, so. Ah! Ah! No! Maybe the microphone.
What?
My nut!
Hold it.
Where'd it go? Hey. Thanks, Melly.
Oh, I told my dad about college.
What?
He was
hyped. Pretty good. Hell yeah. Yay, new wheels! Shake it to make sure there's no noise, that everything's nice and tight. Check your toe stop. Yeah, these baddies are ready to roll. Nice. All right, everyone, here are our new wheels with our skates. I think they look really cool, and I love that they have like the little glitter. I can't wait to try them out right now. I hope you found this video useful, and if you liked it, please subscribe to my channel. Make sure to give this video a like and share it with anyone who you think might find this useful. If you like my content and you would like to support me even more, then make sure to check out my Etsy shop, where I have some stickers and some merch and some art made by me. Or you could buy me a coffee on Ko-fi, which I will also leave the link down below. And again, all this stuff is from pigeonskates.com, so if you guys need anything, then make sure to check out their website. They're freaking awesome and I love them. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Karen the Karrot, and I'll see y'all later. I'm about to lace these up and we can go skate.